greetings of the day. My name is Deepak Rawat and I'm from IIHM Delhi. Today we will be preparing chicken korma, which is a standard dish of all over India, which is a little bit spicier. So now we are going to prepare it. For making chicken korma, we will be using whole spices, chopped onion, ginger garlic paste, a bit of tomato puree. The spices which we'll be putting will be red chili powder, cumin powder, coriander powder, whole grinded garam masala, salt, kasturi methi, and yogurt. And we have the chicken which has been already marinated in ginger garlic paste and salt. So heat up the pan, the first thing. When the pan gets heated up, we have to add the oil in it. Add whole spices. Let it crackle a little bit and give the flavoring. Add chopped onions. Stir it. Add a bit of salt. And cook it till it gets a light brown color. Now when the onion has started to get a golden brown color, we will add ginger garlic in it. The ginger garlic paste, we have the ratio 40% garlic and 60% of ginger. Cook it till the time the fragrance from the ginger garlic starts to come out. Some people prefer to put white pepper in the korma if it has to be on the whitish side. But we will be putting red chili to give a shine when the oil is floating on the top. So when you cook it, add a bit of water. Your ginger garlic paste shouldn't feel burnt out while you are cooking it. Now add red chili powder. Stir a bit. A bit of cumin powder. Coriander powder, a pinch of garam masala, addition of a salt little bit, and green chilies. Now add fresh tomato puree, which is made out of freshly crushed and boiled tomatoes, a bit. It is for the coloring purposes. Some of the people in the Mughlai cuisine, they don't put this at all. Now when this is ready and the flavors are coming out, add few pieces of chicken which has already been marinated, lightly marinated. And just stir cook it. Do not add any water because the chicken, it has already having a lot of water in it, so it will cook on its own. So it's this process, you can already say it's like bhuna. Now when the chicken is almost 70% done, we will add curd. And stir it up continuously till the time it boils. And after the first boil, we will be simmering it out. Now if you can see, there is a boil coming, bubbling coming. Stir it around and lower the temperature. Do not cook the chicken at a high heat. Let it simmer down on its own. So as it is a stew, it has to be covered almost 80% in its own gravy. And now we are going to simmer it out for approximately half an hour. Now the chicken korma is ready. It has been simmered out for almost half an hour. We will be putting kasuri methi, which has been toasted on the side. Some of the people like to put green coriander. The choice of herbs is all yours. Stir it around. If you want to make it more rich, you can add desi ghee, you can add butter. It depends on your choice. So we will add 1 spoon of butter in it. To give it a little bit richness. And stir it out. Let it cook for another 1 minute. Now the chicken korma is ready. So we're gonna serve it in a bowl. Garnish it with fried onions and a little bit of green chili and a piece of coriander. So thank you very much and have a nice time.